Good morning to all. It's my pleasure to invite our first presenter, Dr. Samanthi De Silva. Dr. Samanthi will make a presentation on private health sector. She started her career in private sector just after her internship, and now she has reached the top in private health sector. She works as direct operations in a group of hospitals. She will give you the opportunities and benefits of being in private sector. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Good morning to you all. I'll take you briefly through career opportunities in the private sector. And I think the speakers before you, especially Dr. Kuldi Sanaika, was talking to you about the ability to earn a lot of money in certain specialties. And I think the obstetrician was talking to you about uncontrollable working hours. So there are many factors to determine when you pick a career path. And I believe whatever you choose, it has to be a balance between lifestyle, the satisfaction in what you do, and also, of course, have adequate financial stability. And I also believe our decisions on which path to take is also influenced by whom we interact during our studentship and whom we look up to as role models in our chosen path. So those also affect what you want to do. When we say private sector, a lot of people only look at private hospitals. But private sector, there are many other aspects where you could make a good career path. So hospitals is one, but of course, other than hospitals, there's also general practitioner where you become your own sole entrepreneur. But there is a talk by a GP later on, so I won't elaborate on that. But other than that, healthcare quality is one aspect, especially in the private sector in Sri Lanka. A lot of international accreditation, so that's an emerging role and opportunity. Insurance and other corporates, very well paid. There are many opportunities where you could have a very good career and a good lifestyle and also contributing in a chosen field. Healthcare IT, Prof. Vajira just mentioned the opportunities, and in the private sector, use of IT technology and innovation using electronic digital health. Lots of opportunities available, and it will expand. And that will be a good opportunity if you get into health informatics and then look at a career locally. Pharmaceutical research development, again, is a very lucrative career and a good lifestyle. I'll just briefly take you through. These are some of the things I listed, but of course, there are others. If you're joining a private sector, you can join at various levels. If you are joining after board certification as a consultant, of course, why would you join a private sector? Number one, of course, there will be a guaranteed good payment, either as a salary or as a retainer on a consultancy fee. And of course, you have a very good work environment. You are in control of your operational decisions, your department, the ability to care the way you want, your protocols, SOPs. And of course, you'll be given the best medical technology infrastructure as long as you justify why you need what you're going to do with it. Investments happen faster compared to government sector. So I believe as a clinician, you are able to deliver good clinical outcomes in a setting, in an ideal setup, in quite often. But of course, if you are going to join private sector at a lower level, when you are a house officer or as a GP, again, it's not bad because you get a good work environment, good opportunity to earn, flexibility with your personal needs with regard to traveling, work hours. If you are going to do part-time studies, that will be a good option. Meanwhile, so you have a regular income as well as ability to continue your studies. And potential for career growth, either in clinical path or in non-clinical path. And of course, even in the private sector, there's misconception there won't be prospects or opportunity to learn further. But there are lots of opportunities if you choose a good organization, your career development, as well as competency development is planned. And other than in hospitals, as a medical officer, you also get opportunities in companies and corporates. Some are with pretty good deals. Other than in a clinical role, you could also choose an administrative role. You can get in a clinical role as a junior medical officer and plan your career if you are interested in administrative roles. So in a hospital setup, if you get chief medical officer, general manager, medical director, chief executive, these are also good prospective roles for a person who's interested in administration. And also on the other hand, there are other roles such as occupational health, sports medicine, etc. If you are trying to shift from a clinical role to an administrative role, having an additional qualification like a master's or MBA or a CIMA might add a lot of value, and you might be at the edge when it comes to an opportunity if you have to compete with someone else. Non-clinical career, some of these things were highlighted earlier. Health informatics, I believe, has very good prospects in the future, not only here, but overseas. I've like worked with some of the local health informatics professor. Vajira was highlighting, we have worked well with R3s. They have been doing consultancy for us. And I know during the time of 2 years we worked with them, most of them are now doing very good jobs overseas, in both UK, Australia, and in States. Medical writing journalism can be a part-time opportunity or even full-time if you are good. And healthcare consultancy, insurance companies, food and nutritious products, educational institutes, training development aspects are also opportunities if you really pursue. Pharmaceutical, I spoke to you about. Physicians as entrepreneurs and innovators. I believe some of you would know during COVID time, a lot of digital health platforms emerged, and some of those are pioneered by doctors who actually created platforms for doctors work remotely. And those have become very successful businesses within a very short time. And insurance field underwriting is a very lucrative field globally. Why would you choose private healthcare if you come across a junction to decide? Just to elaborate a little bit, one thing is like remuneration-wise, private sector pays better if you are good. It all depends on the ability for you to negotiate what you deserve. And medical insurance, foreign travel, training, and it's a performance-driven culture. So usually in a private sector, your performance is measured and your incentive increments bonuses are in par with what you deliver. And there is faster growth in earning capacity and year-on-year growth in what you earn. And career development and prospective promotions, if you are clever and if you have a good personality, I think that's something, some place where you can shine. And as at the beginning I highlighted, it creates a better work-life balance opportunity and also for personal and family needs. And you can choose where to work based on your location, your children's schooling, and so on. And sometimes in certain institutions, you can actually work towards getting into a shareholding or owning a business or becoming a partner of a growth of a company. And if you are somebody who's planning to migrate later on, working in a private sector might be helpful because you get used to working with electronic health records and latest technology in similar environment when you travel overseas. And most private hospitals are internationally accredited, so the standards, protocols, guidelines are in par with what you see in other countries. So your change management is easier. If you're planning to join a private sector, my simple advice is if you're planning, join a big group so that it can afford and it will be a sustainable job. And it will be an accountable organization. And then it will be in line with your thinking on ethics, professionalism, values, and delivering good quality care. And if you are going to be in the private sector in the long term, you need to plan what you want to be later. Like, I mean, whether, if not, like there won't be a career prospect. You need to plan what level you join and then where you want to be in 5, 10, 15 years. And more than that, if you are coming to private sector, you need to be able to change. You need to be able to work with IT. You need to be able to handle and work with people in the corporate. The hierarchies are not there. It's very flat organization, first name culture. Sometimes doctors struggle to behave and adapt to those changes. IT literacy becomes a must. Management styles are different. Leadership styles, performance culture. Those things you need to be able to embrace and work with. So those are a few things that you need to consider if you want to. I'm available if you want to ask any further questions. But I believe as a medical degree in our studentship, all we are taught is to look at facts and make decisions. So decision-making ability is what we thrive on. And that ability, if you are good in, I think you can thrive in any corporate sector company at the top level. Thank you.